In this video, I'm going to show you how you can track internal promotions like banners on your homepage with the help of Google Analytics Enhanced E-commerce Tracking and Google Tag Manager. All and more coming up right after this. Hey there, and welcome back to another video of MeasureSchool.com teaching you the data-driven way of digital marketing. My name is Julian, and today I want to answer a question from our Measure Masters community. Measure Master Marco asks, how can I install enhanced e-commerce promo tracking with the help of a custom JavaScript variable? Thanks for this question, Marco. We actually need to define a few things up front. What is enhanced e-commerce promotion tracking? Well, the enhanced e-commerce tracking is a feature set of Google Analytics that carries throughout different reports in Google Analytics, and you can track a whole lot with this, but we want to focus on the promotion tracking. Now, what is promotions in the sense of the enhanced e-commerce tracking? Promotions are, for example, banners on your homepage where you actually want to bring the user deeper into the website or make him aware of a certain promotion that is going on right now. So for example, you could have a banner on the homepage saying, we have 20% off on our shoes right now. So if the user clicks on this, then he goes to the category and he buys later the product maybe. Now you want to track how many people actually viewed this promotion and then clicked on it and ultimately bought, right? With the enhanced e-commerce tracking, promotion tracking, you can do all of this. Now, Marco is asking here about how he can do this with a custom JavaScript variable, which is really interesting because normally you would need to deploy extensive data layers in order to track enhanced e-commerce tracking. We can do this all now with the help of Google Tag Manager, at least in the promotion tracking part of it, because we can make use of a custom JavaScript variable. This gives us the information that we want to send over to Google Analytics, and we can do this all with the built-in tracking mechanisms of Google Tag Manager. We can utilize the element visibility trigger to track the view and then also the click with our click tracking trigger. And this is what I want to show you in this tutorial. Now, it got a bit longer, so I split it up in two parts. In this first part, we're going to take a look at how we can actually track the view, and this is done with the element visibility trigger. And then in the second video, we're going to take a look at how we can track the actual click on our promotion with the help of the click trigger. Now we got lots to cover, so let's dive in. Welcome to the Enhanced E-commerce Tracking Demo Shop. This is something you can access yourself at enhancedecommerce.appspot.com. And this shop was built by Google to show off how you need to implement the enhanced e-commerce tracking to get full functionality of it. In order to see what needs to be implemented into the data layer, you can always click on this information icon here. And you see if the user clicks on this product, we need to deploy this kind of data layer. But today we want to concentrate on a particular data layer, and this is the promo data layer. Right here we have a promotion going on, and when we click on it, we go to a product and then we can buy the product. Now, in the enhanced e-commerce tracking specification, you can in particular track when the user sees this promotion impression and then also clicks on it. And the data layer that you need to implement for the click is this data layer right here. And for the view, we actually have that on the page view when the page loads. Now we have product impressions here, but also down below here we have the promo view. So these are two data layers that would need to be sent over for the impression or promo data to work. Once that data is available and sent over to Google Analytics, what would it look like? If we go over to Analytics, we can go under the conversions, then under e-commerce and marketing, then internal promotions. This is where the data would show up. If we have enhanced e-commerce tracking installed, you could see the name of the promotion, then how many times it was seen, how many times it was clicked, and from there it calculates the CTR. And if the user has bought a particular product later on, we would be able to also see the transactions that are connected to this internal promotion click. So really interesting data. By the way, you can also use this for non-e-commerce tracking websites. It is just what Google Analytics calls an enhanced e-commerce tracking feature. And if you are flexible and can ignore the e-commerce label, you can also track, for example, internal promotions for a lead generation website or certain elements on the homepage that you want to classify as promotions.
Now, in order to get that data in there, you normally would need to deploy these data layers on your page. So every time somebody clicks, this data layer needs to be pushed into Google Tag Manager's data layer. From there, Google Tag Manager can pick that up via a page view or an event tag and send that on to Google Analytics. In this video, I want to show you how you can accomplish this with the help of custom JavaScript. Why do I want to show you this? Well, there are cases where you really have only one promotion on your shop. So for example, here on our shop, we have one ad that is down here. It also goes to a product page and would be perfect for our internal promotions, but we don't want to go back and forth with the developer. We know that there's just one ad here that we want to track, and this is actually pretty nicely done with a click trigger and an element visibility trigger. So how would we set something up like this? Let's start at the beginning. We would need to have the information that we gather from our data layers here inside of our custom JavaScript variable somehow. Let's set up these variables first. So I'm gonna go over to the specification of the enhanced e-commerce tracking for Google Tag Manager. It gives us here all the different data layers that you can set up. We want to concentrate on measuring promotions, and let's first of all look at measuring promotion impressions, so the actual view. It gives us this data layer here. Let's simply copy it and go over to Google Tag Manager. And under variables, we're gonna build a custom JavaScript variable. And a custom JavaScript variable always needs an anonymous function. So you need to enter an anonymous function and a return statement. Now in this anonymous function, we want to implement our data layer right here, but we don't want to push actually to the data layer. We have all the information available for Google Tag Manager to send on to Google Analytics. So what we can do is actually just push our e-commerce data layer. In that case, we would simply get rid of that data layer push here, and also at the end, we want to get rid of our parentheses, and that way now we have a simple enhanced e-commerce object installed here. Now, what do we want to do with this object? We actually want to return it. So I'm going to put the return statement in front of our object here, and it will simply return an object with our promo view information in there. It's correctly formatted because we took it out of the specification, and we can now customize this data layer. Now, in this particular data layer, you need to know a little bit about how you can read data layer information. I want to actually not track two promotions. Two promotions are tracked here. I only want to track one promotion. So I'm going to get rid of this first promotion here. And then I want to customize this. So every promotion needs to have an ID. It doesn't matter which ID you give them. Only if this is a ad that comes up over and over again, you want to have the same ID. Just going to go with one here. We will name this ID. In our case, it is an ad for the Flying Ninja. Now you can put in a different creative if you have different creatives for this Flying Ninja and a position. These, by the way, are pushed into dimensions that you can also access via the secondary dimension. So if you put in creative here, we have internal promotion creative. This would be the creatives, and we also have the position. So if you want to customize them, you can. For me, this doesn't really matter because I just have one single ad. So I'm gonna just keep this as skyscraper and slot 2. But if you want to customize them, go ahead. All right, let's give this all a name. This is a custom JavaScript variable for our enhanced e-commerce promotion view. And let's just try this out to see what the preview in debug mode says about our variable. So we can check whether it was correctly formatted and everything is running. So let's go to variables, and we see here our custom JavaScript variable is now of the return type object, and it simply has an enhanced e-commerce tracking object in here. This is the information that Google Analytics needs in order to build these reports here. So now we would need to transfer this somehow to Google Analytics. How would we do that? Well, through Google Tag Manager and a Google Analytics tag. Let's go over to tags here and build a new Google Analytics tag. And this time it will be an event tag because we just want to send this data over. It needs to have something to transport it, and I will choose event. And this will be a event promotion view. As a tag configuration, we take our Google Analytics tag, and as a track type, this time I choose event. This will be a category of enhanced e-commerce, and as the action promo view, it doesn't really matter what you put in here. This is just the event that transports it over, but I will choose the non-interaction hit true because I don't want it to mess with my bounce rate. And as the Google Analytics settings variable, I have this already prepared, so it goes to the right account. Now we need to tell this tag to pick up this enhanced e-commerce tracking data that we had prepared. So I'm going to go with the enable override settings and go to more settings. And here under the e-commerce section, I can enable the enhanced e-commerce tracking. This one will be set to true. Then I can specify if I want to use the data layer or read from a variable. Now in normal enhanced e-commerce tracking, you would have the data layer filled and then pick up the data from there. So you would use the data layer, but in our case, we can choose the custom JavaScript EE promo view that we have just prepared. All right, that should do it. Just to show you what data will be sent over, we also want to check under the advanced configurations, the use debug version true. This will transport some information into our developer tools so we can actually see these enhanced e-commerce tracking data being sent to Google Analytics. So I'm going to set this to true for now. Later, if you actually publish this, I would go back and set this to false because you don't want to have that data always in your debug console. All right, and then we just need to choose a trigger. Which trigger do we choose? We have an all pages trigger. That would obviously mean that the ad would be triggered or the promo view would be triggered on all the pages. We only want it to be seen on our particular page here. How can we target this page or every time the ad is seen? This is actually pretty far down. So at the beginning that the user can actually see it. So I don't want to send an impression over once the user lands actually on a page, only if he scrolls down and sees this ad. And this is something you can use the element visibility trigger for. So let's go ahead and build one. I'm gonna go here to the plus and as a type, we'll choose element visibility. And now we can select a method to actually trigger this, either an ID or CSS selector. Obviously you would need to know a little bit of CSS and figure out what the right selector is. I'm gonna go here and right click and go to inspect element. And this will give me the HTML markup. And luckily for us, we have here our section of the ad, and it has an ID media image 2. So I'm just gonna double click on that and copy it and fill that into the ID. In most cases, you would probably need to use a CSS selector, which gets more complicated as you try to filter down on the elements that actually should be viewed here. So I'm going to go with the ID though, and I can choose whether this should fire every time the element is seen. This would be this one, once per element. So if you have multiple elements, only once it will fire, or once per page. I will choose once per page for our example here. And how much should be seen of that element? 50% is fine with me. Now I don't need to really choose any filters here, as this will only fire if the media image 2 is actually seen. Now let's just give this a name. This is a visibility trigger for our ad. Let's save and save this again here. And now let's try this all out. Refresh our page. Well, it's already fired here because it's just down there. Let's reload again. Somehow remembers where I was at that time. Now let's go to another category here. Let's go to the t-shirts and see if this works. Okay, now we are on the t-shirts page and we're just going to scroll down and we see element visibility now fired and our EE promo view has fired as well. Now, this information is sent over to Google Analytics. How can we make sure that this was actually sent? That's where this debug view came in that we have activated in our tag. We can open up the developer tools again, right click inspect element. And here under the console, we should now have information available of what data was actually sent over to Google Analytics. First of all, we had our page view. This is something that fires normally on the page as we have a page view trigger installed. And then afterwards, we should see an event. And this event should have our enhanced e-commerce tracking data in here as well. So here's our event. And we also sent over an EC ad promo, and this is our ID, our name, and so on. So this was sent over to Google Analytics correctly. We can look this up in the account. On the real-time reports, here under events, we see events last 30 minutes. We have our enhanced e-commerce tracking promo view that was sent over. Now this only tells us that the event was received by Google Analytics, but did it actually pick up the right information from our enhanced e-commerce tracking data layer or the e-commerce object that we send over. Let's go over to our conversions, and under e-commerce, marketing, internal promotions, we need to set the right date. Just gonna pick the last date, and here we see some information already being received. So we have here our internal promotion and our promotion views, and the clicks are something that I've tested out beforehand, which we're gonna get to in a second. All right, so this is how you can already send over information about the promo view. In the next video, we're gonna take a look at how we can send over our click data to Google Analytics as well.